have a few showers around today, but not a bad day at all. I want to show you the loop from 3D Pinpoint Doppler last night, and look at that heavy rainfall move over Portland. This is a six-hour loop, so it starts around midnight. You probably heard the rain hammering your windows in the overnight hours, and here is what we're left with. Well, we have dry conditions from Portland down through Woodburn and Salem, down to Jefferson and Albany. It's up to the north where we have a little bit of shower activity still near Woodland and Longview. And then as you head over to the Coast Range, Banks and Forest Grove, seeing a little bit of light rain this morning. Take a look at some of these rainfall totals. This is just since midnight. Pretty insane. Troutdale, almost an inch of rain in the first about 7 hours of today. Elsewhere, still very impressive. 3/10 or more than 3/10 of an inch in some locations around Portland and Hillsboro. How about PDX? Well, look at this. Since Saturday, we have had more than an inch and a half of rainfall. So it has been a soggy weekend, and it's going to be a soggy start to the week and all week long. In fact, I think through Halloween, we have plenty of rain on the way. 61 degrees in downtown Portland, a mild start to the day. 59 in Eastmoreland, 58 in Longview. You have to keep in mind, these are typical highs for this time of year. So really mild, feels warm outside. 52 degrees in the Dalles and 54 in Bend. We have a bit of a break in the activity, and you can see that off in the Pacific, but take a look at what's headed our way later on tonight into tomorrow morning. This plume of clouds originated near Hawaii, so we've got lots of moisture headed our way, taking aim for us again later on tonight. And I'll pinpoint everything out for you here on Raincast. You can see drying out quite nicely. Overcast, just a few stray showers around as the day wears on. That's 4 o'clock tonight. But by 10 o'clock, we get that steadier rainfall moving on in. Segs down to the south and then pushes back north again by 6 o'clock tomorrow morning. We'll be wet at times through your Tuesday. Looks like a fairly soggy day. And this is Wednesday, your Halloween. And 7 o'clock, we still look pretty wet for trick-or-treaters from the coast all the way through the Cascades. So just get those garbage bags handy, Mom and Dad. We have got now Hurricane Sandy, a Category 1, sustained winds 85 miles per hour right now, set to make landfall late tonight, early tomorrow morning. Our model projects 75 mile per hour sustained winds when it makes that landfall. And what I find fast, it'll eventually move off to the north. What I find fascinating is this tapestry of watches and warnings we've got going in the Northeast. All of these oranges, those are high wind warnings, high wind watches in the tan color there. We've got, of course, coastal flooding warnings there because of the storm surge that we have real concern about. And then we're looking at winter storm warning and blizzard warnings also there in the mountains. So a lot to wrap your mind around. This is a huge storm, and we'll be tracking it quite closely here in the Pinpoint Weather Center. Wet at times out at the coast and breezy today with temperatures in the upper 50s. Back in the I-5 corridor, temperatures in the mid-60s to finish off the day with a few showers around east of the Cascades. Through the gorge, bit breezy, winds out of the west 10 to 20 miles per hour. Wet at times, not all the time, scattered showers over Mount Hood. And then back around the metro today, not too bad of a day. And it's going to be a beautiful evening to head out and check out the Oregon Symphony, 8 o'clock tonight. Beautiful show in store. And I think you can just expect overcast skies. By the time you're leaving the theater, you might be seeing some rain starting to move in. So tomorrow looks soggy, so does Wednesday. Wednesday and Thursday, wet at times, some showers. Friday looks like a pretty nice day with morning fog, afternoon sun. Carly